And the lad teaches us. The lad teaches us all a practical lesson here. And the lesson is, whenever there is a need, give it all you have to Jesus and let him do the rest. Because if you can do the possible, God can do the impossible. You hear me? You hear me online? If you can do the possible, God can do the impossible. And after commanding his disciples to sit, the 5,000 men plus women and children down, the Bible says that Jesus gave thanks. And by giving thanks, he lets us know that all good and perfect gifts come from God. And now every good thing in life that we enjoy, even though it's seemingly small, like the lad's lunch, we still need to be grateful. Let us not whine about whine for something greater. Instead, he needs, if God meets your needs, let's be glad that he provides and give him thanks. Now then he will enlarge your territory. Give thanks for food. Give thanks for clothing and shelter and a car and a smartphone. Give thanks for a computer, furniture, a television, tables and chairs, electricity, light bulbs, and water. In short, anything that makes life easier to more enjoyable, you should count it as a blessing and give God thanks. And I need to tell you that between giving thanks and distributing to his disciples, God got bread out of biscuits. He got fish out of sardines. He can get a good marriage out of bad marriage. He can get money to pay bills out of bad finances. He can get healing out of a stroke. Hey! Hey, hey! He can get productive kids out of baby kids. But you gotta give thanks. You gotta give thanks. You gotta give thanks. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. When I was in the convalescent home and couldn't move, and some of the deacons and some of the members know I couldn't move. I was in the convalescent home, and but one day I got a little feeling in my fingers, and I said, thank you. I started being able to move my shoulders, and I said, thank you. Then I got feeling in my legs, and I said, thank you. And here